Hi, my name is Dale Dierdorf. I am pleased to teach QSO 640 Project Management here at SNU. After retiring from a major aerospace company as a project and program manager, I transitioned into an enterprise consulting role. I have over 30 years of experience in organizational management and leadership. The reason I enjoy teaching and facilitating in the SNU MBA program is because the students are looking for what I'll call a stronger focus on the subject of project management. By that, they want me to explore the focus areas with an independent perspective. That independent perspective means that they get an opportunity to learn not only from me, but from the other students. And I'm here today to talk to you about a technique I learned and have used for over 15 years to be successful in project management called microscheduling. All of us use project management techniques and principles every day. When we decide to buy a car, when we decide to buy a house, when we plan a vacation, or we take our kids' activities and their workflows and we create schedules and plans that demand flexibility. In project management, we have many different scheduling views we can use. Let's take a peek at a couple of them. So let's start with the Gantt chart, and that's that view that you've got at the bottom of the screen. That Gantt chart gives you the opportunity to look at a project, seeing the elements, the milestones, with predecessor and successor logic based on it. Now, the view above that is a network diagram, which shows us how to see the intersections of these activities in a flow. A PERT diagram shows us the ability to see what we would call lag and lead and, you know, resource time allocations. But we need one single view of a project many times to help us and our teams focus on what needs to be done right and what needs to be done right now and next. So, what I'm going to talk to you about is a technique called microscheduling. So let's just take a situation where you're going to plant a tree. The first thing I need you to do is just create the list of things that need to be done, those elements that would be considered pieces of a work breakdown structure, but we're just going to call it the list of things that have got to be created to plant a tree, okay? So you list those, and in this particular situation, we have 12 different activities that are required to plant a tree. Now, the next piece I'm going to have you do is just take a piece of paper and draw 12 squares, and then in those 12 squares, go ahead and translate that information. All of that information that you had from the other sheet goes into these boxes in a hierarchical order, and all you're doing is looking for the opportunity to translate that information from that list into a bare bones chart. Now, that bare bones chart then is going to have some details put into it. Those details that we're talking about are going to be the start and finish dates based upon the durations. So you can see in my original chart, I laid down the days, how long it's going to take, and then I took a schedule and I started with a March date in 2021 and laid out if it's a one-day duration, it starts on this day, ends on that same day, and I created that path. This would be called our baseline start and our baseline finish dates. And we create that all the way across the chart. Now, what that does is it gives us the ability to see what this would look like when we put it all together. Now, I have another opportunity for us. I'm going to pull up another file because I like to do this in Microsoft Visio. So I'm going to go ahead and pull up a Visio file. In this Visio file, you can now see all of those elements that we were talking about, how they're placed together. Now, the advantage of this is that I can take and I can manipulate this. So once I've got my initial dates in, okay, I can come back. This particular situation here is one where if we take this snapshot and we look at it and I wanted to change this to be something that is more than 50% complete, I can drag and drop that up to 80%. And then I can change this over here to be 80%. Any of these text dates can be manipulated and changed. And you can do this in a variety of different programs. I like to do it in Excel, but I mean in Visio, but I've done it in PowerPoint and I've done it in Excel. So that's what this looks like. Now, let's take a peek at when we get into looking at a more complex schedule. So say that schedule that I was showing you that I put together previously runs into a situation, and you can see in the task over here where we put fertilizer in whole and we mix it with the loose dirt, I run into a situation where I only have a half a bag of fertilizer. So I have to stop that activity. It stops. This is a way to show that happening. So you can see that the 50% mark I put in red, it shows that the project is on hold there. The blue dates underneath are the actual start and finish dates. So remember, the top is the baseline start and finish date, and then progressively, as you're filling the chart in, you get a good sense of if you're on track, on schedule, and we call this micro scheduling. Now, the big things I want you to walk away from micro scheduling with is I want you to always develop it with your team. Share it with everyone involved and ask everyone and anyone that you are interfacing with, is there anything preventing us from completing this? Are there any steps that we're missing? And then finally, the last thing is make sure you put your name on the chart in the areas that you're accountable for, and then have other people tell you the spots they're accountable for. That accountability is what will help you be successful in project management using the tool micro scheduling. Have a great one. Bye-bye.